Well, welcome to Technology and Education Today. We are coming to you from the South by Southwest EDU conference in Austin, Texas. I'm Richard Smith, and I'm talking with Krishna Vedati of Tinker. And Tinker is a company that produces a method of programming.
Tinker is a creative computing platform where kids can learn to code or learn to program.
Well, that's certainly said better than I have. I said. And what makes it special?
It makes it special because it enables kids to learn programming through fun activities. So where kids can build games, they can build art, they can build music, animation, things that they love. And then it brings out the imagination, creativity in them. And we get out of the way and then let them build things. And in that process, they learn how to think like a programmer and learn some of the skills.
Well, what makes this language is it easy for the students to use? And if so, what makes it so easy to use?
So we've kind of taken inspiration from systems like Scratch, where we built a visual programming environment where the language is designed like a set of Lego blocks, where it's organized these blocks from their thought process and not worry about syntax, and so that syntax doesn't get in the way. So that way it's very easy for them.
So how would this differ from a program such as Logo? Because I remember Logo in the 1980s was the big thing, and I think it was Seymour Papert that was going to solve all the problems of public school education. We had Logo Lighthouse schools. What makes Tinker different? Why?
I think Tinker has taken inspiration from Logos and Scratches of the world, but it's kind of evolved the language into a mainstream, a little bit mainstream. So it has object-oriented orientation. It has the primitives to build physics-based games. It actually brought it to mainstream. More importantly, we brought it to a browser. So kids just need a browser, and they just work there, and then they can be able to transport their creations via open internet.
So if all it requires is a browser, does that mean this can be used on a tablet?
Yes, it can be. Although today we have a limited version of it on tablets where they can solve puzzles. Over time, they will have a tablet-based creation tool as well.
Now, has this been released yet?
No, it's not been released. It's been only released, given to a limited set of schools in Bay Area. And we're looking to give to a larger number of schools in South by Southwest EDU. But it's been well tested by many kids.
Oh, what's been the reaction of the kids?
Kids, we are very surprised the kind of creations that kids can build out using this.
What have they built?
You know, they've built lots of kids built games. A lot of kids built storybooks. A lot of big animations. They're asking us a lot of features. We're constantly innovating so that we satisfy their needs, and they want to have multi-level games.
Mm-hmm. What's been the teacher's reaction to it?
You know, teacher's reaction has been very good in the sense of it kind of unlocks the STEM skills. Like, you know, kid is learning math in school, but they're able to apply that into a game that they're creating. So it kind of unlocks all these skills.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And then they're able to showcase how it's unlocking them. And also it's engaging the kids, and teacher is participating in an engagement. So.
And I think you mentioned music before.
Yes.
How does it work for music?
So what happens is it has a music stencil blocks, like the Lego, the blocks you see here, and then they can organize to create, like for example, they can create a music band from various music instruments and control through programming versus manually.
Well, that's super fantastic. I'm really looking forward to when this thing actually gets launched, gets out into the public schools. It'd be great to see what happens. I've been talking with Krishna Vedati of Tinker. I'm Richard Smith. You've been watching Technology and Education Today.
Thanks, Richard. Thanks for taking the time. Appreciate it.